I've been quite a fan of Mandrake and Mandriva Linux for decades, so when the OpenMandriva team announced a new release, I knew I had to try it. Does OpenMandriva Lx 6.0 fix some issues I had with 5.0? Would it be the distro to recommend to anyone getting into Linux? I hope so. Let's find out. First thing I'd like to try is booting and installing from Ventoy. While the previous version booted fine from Ventoy, I never had any luck actually installing it that way. Well, it boots fine, and pretty fast I should say, I did not speed up this boot process. Welcome to OpenMandriva. New features? Seems the same. There's the configure tab, where you can basically configure your whole system. The software tab with some picks from the OpenMandriva team that you can simply install by clicking on one of those icons. Look, they even made it easy to install Steam and Lutris. Repositories, contribute. Yeah, okay, let's try to install. Not connected to the internet, with a capital I, as this old prick learned it at school. But yeah, let's plug it in first. Alright, connected. It doesn't pick it up automatically. Let's close it and try again. No more warning. Hoo-hoo! Let's see if I can select Amsterdam with a single click. Yeah! Keyboard settings. You know what? I actually like to have dead keys. Erase disk or manual partitioning. Well, there's nothing to erase on this empty SSD, but let's try that option. No swap? Let's pick enough to hibernate. My name and such. Hey ho, let's go! Creating partitions. I believe 5.0 got this far as well. Filling file system, it works! All done, restart now. Yes! There we are, on our freshly installed system. I like it a lot that I can use Ventoy on OpenMandriva now as well. What graphics driver are we using? AMD GPU, that's a plus. One thing that is different in this release is that there's not a separate control center anymore. You control everything from this welcome screen. Let's install Zim, my favorite note-taking application. Yes, I'd like to install it. Enter my password. Still have to do that twice. Okay. And there it goes. Succeeded.
Where is it?
Oh, it's under utilities. Not the place I would expect for a note-taking app. Yeah, the default is fine. Woohoo! If you want to know more about Zim and why I like it so much, check out this video. What more do we have? GIMP, let's install that. I wonder if it's the recently released version 3.0. It is! Neat! They also provide an easy way to install Steam. App install. Done. There it is, it's going to update itself first. Log in like you used to. And there we are. Let's do turbo overkill. Right, I have to enable compatibility first. There we go! Right, this might take a while, so let's explore OpenMandriva 6.0 some more. The repositories tab lets you... can't click anywhere? Oh, only the icon is clickable, okay. Right, NAND3 is already enabled, but we kinda knew that because we have just installed Steam. There's a few application-specific repositories over there. Let's try Brave. Right, let's see if we can install it now. Go Configure, Software. Which one? Why are there three options? This doesn't make a lot of sense to me. Let's try DNF Drake. Select Icon Theme. I don't know. This one? DNF Drake was started in user mode. To work correctly, it should be started as super user. Really? Why not just ask for a password when needed? Update notification is not active. Yes, please enable that. What icon theme? Why do you think I care? No browsing, only searching in DNF Drake. No Brave? Browser? No? Does it list NVIDIA packages? I feel we're missing a lot in here. Oh, there's also KDE's Discover tool. So that makes four options. Not a huge fan of that one, but let's see. Does this see Brave? Come on. Yeah, it really seems enabled. Yum Extender. Needs to install first. This seems like a very basic Yum or DNF frontend. It does see Brave though. Let's see if it installs it. Oops. There we go. Transaction completed successfully. Nice. A last graphical option to install software is Find Additional Applications. Cool name. This is DNF Dragora. Looks a lot like Mandriva's old software installation tool. Nice grouped view for browsing packages. We've got the NVIDIA 575 and 470 drivers here, so both my GTX 1050 Ti and my old GTX 670 should work. Only one FPS game? Oh, Quake 3 is just a shooter, not an FPS apparently. Warzone, a fast-paced first-person shooter game. Not an FPS though. Let's install that one. Changes applied. Cool. Right, we installed Brave. I never used that one before, so I'm curious about it. Send reports and products insights? Nope. Yeah, my site works! What's this? Earn tokens for private ads? What the... Fuck off! Let's try Warzone. Could not find any shaders. Did they include a broken game? Ha! Turbo Overkill is done downloading. Woohoo! A bit stuttery. Interesting. Let's check the release notes to see if there's anything worth covering today. What's new? Updates, updates, updates. Nothing too special. That's a good thing though. Release notes. That's interesting. They actually recommend using DNF on the command line to install and update software. Not exactly what I expect as a longtime Mandrake fan. Default sound server switched to Pipewire. I believe that's good news if you want to use pro audio equipment. Not going to dig into that today though, as it shouldn't matter for the average user. Okay, well, nothing too interesting. Let's look at the default software that's installed. What's ScanLite? Seems to be scanner software. Are there a lot of people still using those in 2025? Why is Telegram pre-installed? That seems like a weird choice to me. Some basic multimedia tools. Of course, we've got LibreOffice for our productivity needs. They include Yakwake by default, my favorite terminal application. I don't use it regularly in my videos because zooming in is just easier in console, but I use this way more often in real life because I like the way it just drops down when I hit F12. No updates? Weird. It's almost a day old when I'm filming this. Now let's see if Hibernate works. Looks like it. Network took a second to get back up, but all is working again. Maybe I should have opened a few applications before trying this. Let's try an NVIDIA GPU. Remove the R9290 from my system and add in the GTX 1050 Ti. It works! Rocking the new Vault driver, which is not great for gaming, but fine for general desktop use. Let's install the proprietary NVIDIA driver. Since my GTX 1050 Ti can still be used with the latest drivers, I can just click Configure, Hardware and click the NVIDIA drivers. Oops, maybe I should plug the network cable back in. Try again. There it goes. It's just calling DNF in console. This looks good. Go ahead. Complete. Well, let's reboot and see if it works. Sure looks like it. There it is. Wait, what? I can't move the mouse too fast or something? Okay. Come on! Maybe just reboot. Let's change the SSD for my previous install with Arch Linux. See if that works at all. Just fine, no issues at all. Okay, switch back. Let's disable that NVIDIA driver for a moment. I guess I can just remove this to let the new Vault driver take over. Yes, better. There was an errata message about the NVIDIA drivers. Let's see if it says anything about this. Not really. So I guess you better stay away from the closed source NVIDIA drivers or from OpenMandriva if you want to game and have an NVIDIA graphics card. Or you could just play a card game. Well, guess what? I just restarted the computer the day after to record some B-roll, and now it works. I have changed nothing. No updates or anything. Just turned it off yesterday evening and booted it up just before starting to edit this video. Well, I did try to install X-Wayland, but that didn't help yesterday. Interesting. Okay, let's see if Turbo Overkill runs. It does! Well, I guess that's all I have for you today. I hope you liked this video. Thank you very much for watching. Until next time.